What is estimate at completion EAC in EVM? You might know the definition of EAC, but do you understand the formulas? Let's figure them out. Hey, this is Praveen Malik from PMbyPM.com, your ultimate resource for the PMP exam prep. I have made it my mission to help you pass the PMP exam in your first try. In this video, I'm going to talk about EAC. By the end of this video, you'll understand the EAC formulas. Stay tuned. Before we go ahead, please subscribe to this channel and click on bell icon. This way, whenever I release a new informative video, you'll get an instant notification. Let's start by looking at the definition of EAC. The expected total cost of completing all work expressed as the sum of the actual cost to date and the estimate to complete. Let's look at a simpler definition. How much money is needed to complete total project work? In both the definitions, we are talking about completing total project work. Let's understand it with the help of a diagram. So on the control date, some work would have been completed while some other work would be remaining. So monetary value of the completed work can be expressed as earned value or EV. And the monetary value of the total work can be expressed as budget at completion or BAC. To understand these terms, you can click on the card above to watch my previous video. Let's look at the project budget again. So on control date, we have already completed some work which can be expressed as EV, and we have already spent some money which can be expressed as AC, but we need to do some more work which can be expressed as ETC or estimate to complete. To understand ETC, you can click on the card above to watch my previous video. Now on the control date, our original budget may not be sufficient to complete the project work. So we will need to revise the project budget. So instead of BAC, we might need more funds to complete the project work. We can forecast a new budget, which is called EAC or estimate at completion. Let's look at a formula for calculating EAC. Now this is our picture from the previous slide. You will notice that EAC is equal to expenditure till date plus estimated future expenditure. So our formula could be EAC is equal to AC plus ETC. Let's look at our example project. So on the control date, we have completed 35 out of 80 tables. And we have spent $36,000 for building these 35 tables. 45 tables are still remaining. In the previous video, we had calculated ETC as $46,286. Now, if we put the values in our formula, EAC is equal to AC plus ETC, we get $82,286. It simply means that project team will require $82,286 to build the 80 tables. Let's look at another EAC formula. So let's go back to our example project. So our plan was to build 80 tables in 5 days with an estimate of $1,000 per table. The total project budget or BAC was $80,000. On the day 3 of the project, the status looks something like this. We had to complete 40 tables, but we actually completed only 35 tables. And cost of building these tables was $36,000. So our PV was $40,000, EV was $35,000, and AC was $36,000. The BAC was $80,000. So in our example project, we have already completed 35 out of 80 tables and we have spent $36,000, but we have to complete total of 80 tables. So we have to calculate how much money would be needed to build these 80 tables. Let's calculate it by using a series of pictures. So we have already completed 35 tables. Our earned value is $35,000 and actual cost is $36,000. We have spent more than the budgeted amount. Now we have to build 45 more tables to complete the project scope. The monetary value for these 45 tables is $45,000. So our original budget was $80,000. Now we need to spend some more money to complete the remaining work, which is expressed as ETC. Now ETC could be less than $45,000, it could be equal to $45,000, or it could be more than $45,000. We still have to figure it out. Most likely we will spend more than $45,000 since we are not making good progress. So our EAC is likely to be more than $80,000. Let's look at it again. So we have completed $35,000 worth of work and we have spent $36,000 to complete this work. Now we have to complete work worth of $80,000 and we have to find out how much money would be needed to complete the total project scope. Now this becomes an easy ratio and proportion problem. So mathematically our EAC will be equal to 36,000 divided by 35,000 into 80,000. Now mathematically let's transpose it. So EAC can be equal to 80,000 divided by 35,000 divided by 36,000. So the numerator 80,000 was our original budget or BAC, whereas the denominator 35,000 by 36,000 is CPI or cost performance index. Now we can rewrite it as a formula. EAC is equal to BAC divided by cost efficiency. To understand CPI and cost efficiency, you can click on the card above to watch my previous video. So our EAC formula 2 becomes EAC is equal to BAC by CPI. Let's look at another formula. So our EAC formula 1 was EAC is equal to AC plus ETC. From our ETC video, we know that ETC is equal to BAC minus EV divided by CPI. Let's replace ETC in the EAC formula. So our EAC formula 3 becomes EAC is equal to AC plus BAC minus EV divided by CPI. Let's look at a fourth formula. So let's assume our project scenario is that the project team believes that the project's past performance will not affect the future performance. The irregularities of the past would not be repeated in future. The remaining work would be completed at 100% cost efficiency as per the original estimates. Essentially, the team is saying that 45 tables are remaining and we will be able to build these 45 tables as per the original cost estimate, which is $45,000. So our EAC formula 3 was EAC is equal to AC plus BAC minus EV divided by CPI. Now the team is saying that our cost efficiency will be 100%. So the CPI value will be 100%. Let's replace it. So our EAC formula 4 becomes EAC is equal to AC plus BAC minus EV. I've written a blog post for some other formulas on EAC. You can click on the link in the description below. I have a question for you. Which of the following statements are true? EAC is equal to ETC at the beginning of a project. EAC is equal to BAC at the beginning of a project. EAC is equal to zero at the successful completion of a project. I'm curious to know your opinion. Please comment below. So this was my fifth video in the playlist. You can continue to the next video. If you want to download this PPT, please click on the link in the description below.